Speal. We are going to get into the Hoedown boogie now. I want to show you how I play the riffs to my song Poor But Satisfied. Poor But Satisfied is the last song. It is a closer on the album Stay Primal by Shane Speal and the Snakes. Boom. The CD, it's for sale now. ShaneSpeal.com. If you are shopping for your cigar box guitar parts at CB Giddy, he's got the CD there as well. Add it to your cart. Get the instant download at ShaneSpeal.com as well. Boom. Poor But Satisfied. Okay, when we went into the studio to record this album, I forced the band to listen to Led Zeppelin 3. If you remember, Led Zeppelin 3 is the album that they went acoustic. Half acoustic. And they had songs like Braun Your Ar Stomp. And that's the feel I wanted for Poor But Satisfied. I wanted it acoustic, but I wanted it like a brass knuckles acoustic. So I came up with this riff. It's in this G7th tuning. These 7th tunings are all over my album. I just fell in love with it, and I pursued it as I wrote the songs for this album. So the album has a feel to it, and you hear these 7th tunings just throughout in all different ways, whether it be Memphis Stole style, whether it be Tin Pan Alley, you continue to hear these 7th tunings. Poor But Satisfied on the album is in G7th, and I have this guitar in G7th right now. Let's make sure it's in tune. G7th tuning is G, D, F, B, GDFB, G7th tuning. This is a fun one to play. Once you get the fingering down for that main riff, I guarantee you'll be sitting around the living room playing it. Trust me, I did. It's so much fun. It's this G7th tuning, 4-string cigar box guitar, and it's just this really cool pull-off. It starts with the 3rd string on the 2nd fret. So you hit it and pull off. Hit it, and then you use your finger to pull it off. And then 2nd string, 2nd fret. 1st string, 3rd fret. I'm going to give you a close-up right there. See how I'm only picking it once, but I'm using the finger to ring it out the second time. Pull off. So get back to you. What just happened? Boom. Funny camera. All right, here we go. Boom. Dun, dun, da, 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 da. Boom. So that's the main riff, and you know how blues are 3 chords? For G, it would be G, C, and D. Well, this song is kind of like Braun Your Ar Stomp, where the main riff is on the root chord. But whenever I go to sing, it's on the second chord, which is D7th, 5th fret. What this means is I'm doing the main riff, okay? And then whenever I go to the second chord, that's when I sing the verse. Instead of singing the verse when you're down here. Yeah, da, ba, da, da. No, I only sing once I hit the second chord. So, let's start out here. We've got the first riff. Then I go to the 5th fret, put your finger the whole way across, and we're going to do the Shane chord again. This is all through my album. I have the finger going the whole way across in the fifth fret. Get that close up there. And then I take my ring finger, third string, two frets up from where the bar is, which means you go five. You've got the finger going the whole way across the fifth frets. Use your ring finger and go up to the seventh fret on the third string. See that? I'm making it sound more complicated than it really is. And this song is all about rhythm. Once I hit that second chord, it's... goes like this. And it's so easy. That rhythm I showed you, just do it the same way across the neck. You're starting at the bridge is at the third fret. Put your finger across and use your ring to go two frets up on the third string. So third fret. Fifth fret. Eighth fret. Tenth fret. Do it again. Third fret. Fifth. Eighth. Tenth. And then first riff. Now, this song, I did something I never do before. I never did before. Where it's, I'm poor but satisfied. I go to this A seventh. So the chorus of the song goes, finger across the second fret. Well, I'm poor. And then go to the fifth fret. But satisfied. My voice isn't there right now. It's not 2 in the morning. And that's it. You've got your main riff. And then whenever you go sing, you go to the fifth fret and do the Shane trill. And then there's a bridge where you do that 3, 5, 8, 10. And then the chorus, which is 2 to 5. That's poor but satisfied. This whole, it's all over my album. I do that everywhere. That's right now, that's kind of my cliched riff for this album because I keep using seventh tunings everywhere, whether it be G7th, A7th, or F7th. I just keep using those tunings, and then whenever I bar a chord, I just love hitting that. So, there you go. That is a cool, like, Hoedown boogie-woogie riff. Take it, try your own versions of it, mess around with it, and try to write your own music. Listen, if you're getting anything from these lessons, leave a comment. Leave a comment below. I'd love to hear what you guys think. I am going through every song on the album here and just kind of giving an overview of the riffs. I'm not getting into solos. In fact, this isn't a big solo album to begin with. Stay Primal is more about a jug band feel to it. Less solos, more just fun songs. So leave your comments below. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's youtube.com/ShaneSpiel. Make sure you share this on Facebook. If you're getting something out of my lesson videos, share them on Facebook or on your blogs, on Cigar Box Nation, wherever else. Let people know about them. That helps everyone out. And let me see. What else do I got to do? I've got, like, notes right behind this camera. Oh, yeah. If you want to support what I'm doing, check out stubbyslide.com. Hold on, I didn't do the bell. Stubbyslide.com. That's where I have really cool handmade guitar slides, such as this 50 caliber slide. I've got the Bone Digger ceramic cigar box guitar slides. All of those, and the cool Dive Bar Tour shirt, Scully shirt, they're all at stubbyslide.com. Go build yourself a cigar box guitar, because it's about time. Get your parts at cbgiddy.com. Check me out at shanespiel.com, share this video, and thank you very much. I will see you soon. Bye-bye.